Welcome back to Shop Talk. I'm Ria Tanjuatco Trillo. And with us now is Jason Law, who will talk about growing yourself to grow your business at the two-day financial literacy camp for the youth. And that's happening Wednesday and Thursday next week. Hi, Jason. Thanks for coming on Shop Talk.
Thank you.
Okay, you have a background in marketing and direct selling. So you'll be talking to the kids about entrepreneurship. At what age can you actually start teaching them entrepreneurship?
Well, I think there is no specific age. Mm-hmm. You can teach them entrepreneurship as young as 5 years old, because it's like teaching them about values. These values are caught, not taught. So when they see that you're enjoying doing your business, so you tend to pass it on to them. Because I think one of the problems now of businesses is succession. And they have a saying that there's no success without succession.
Right.
So if you're going to pass it on to the next generation, you need to train them first, and they have to enjoy and see the importance of being an entrepreneur to contribute to our economy.
Okay, what about kids whose parents or even grandparents are mostly employees and not people who own their businesses? Is the approach to teaching entrepreneurship different for them?
Well, I think there are two challenges when you teach kids about entrepreneurship. Mm-hmm. The first one is for those who have businesses already, especially the big ones, is that the kids might have this sense of entitlement, that the money that they're getting or the business that they have is something that they deserve. On the other hand, for those who don't have a business, the problem is that they have to be challenged. Their mindset should be changed, wherein they have to rise to the occasion and to enlarge their mindset that it's possible also for them.
Right, that they can do it.
Yeah.
Okay, so what are the entrepreneurial concepts that you think kids should have early on, no matter what their backgrounds are?
Well, there are many to share, but I think the three most important are, the first one is about character. I'm going to teach this at the Blue Chip seminar. And when you talk about character, it's the foundation of all relationships, because business is all about relationships. And when you talk about character, they have to have that character development, wherein they will see the importance of having integrity, honesty. In fact, if you read the book Millionaire Next Door, it's a bestseller, and it's a research done in the States of the top millionaires there, the real millionaires, and they're not the one who's fancy, who has these nice cars. They buy their cars secondhand. And the top two reasons why they became successful is tied. First one is being honest, and then the second one is they have to work hard. So that's the first one, character, because I believe that business is all about it's all about character. Mm-hmm. So it's all about relationships, and that's the foundation of all relationships, which is trust, which comes from their character. And then the second one is about competence, which talks about their knowledge on how to market themselves. It's really about learning how to sell yourself. So when you do marketing, communicate, right now I'm a full-time pastor, and I think the transition from being a businessman into a pastor is not that hard, because when you're in church, it's also communicating.
Right.
So when you teach them about this, when you teach them how to market ideas, to sell themselves, it's going to be easier for them to show the concepts that they have in mind. Because I believe that in order for you to be successful, you need to learn how to sell ideas. In fact, if you know how to sell ideas, you will never be poor in life. And I think the third one, which is most important, is for them to have a passion as early as now. So as early as when they are still young, if they have that passion in them, they will have a glimpse of what they want to be in the future. So when they have that passion, they can turn that passion into profit. So I guess those are the three concepts, the principles, the tenets that they would need to be successful early on.
Yeah, exactly. When they find their passion early, you know, work won't seem so much like work.
Yeah.
Right? It'll be a lot more enjoyable for them. Maybe you can give us some examples that you would give the kids about real Filipino entrepreneurs who started, entrepreneurship or their own businesses, or helping in their family's businesses when they were really young.
Well, there are many. I think most of the Taipan started young. And you see Lu Shutan, Go Hong Wei. And I think when you share with them stories about young people who started their businesses at a young age, It's not really giving them examples of stories, but I think it's better for them to see it with their parents. So, because the best education comes from home.
Definitely.
So,
okay. What about for you? You know, as a pastor, as a lecturer, what are the challenges that you face when teaching these principles to young people?
Well, I think the challenge is to show them the importance of being an entrepreneur. So for the most part, our school system, sad to say, teaches our kids to be employees. Mm-hmm. And I've heard this from a very successful businessman that our MBAs also teach people how to become employees, executives.
Right. Yeah.
So if you have this paradigm, this mindset of being a businessman, and then you you enroll yourself in an MBA class, then you have both mindsets, which is that of a manager who manages his business well, and that of a businessman who has the vision to enlarge that that endeavor. So I think the biggest challenge really depends on not only showing them the success principles, but as a pastor, I think a challenge for me personally is to show people that there's no divide between God and a business, because God is the center of everything. So I think that's the most important challenge, because we tend to separate both.
That's right. You forget him, you'll be in some kind of trouble. Okay, when it comes to Blue Chip 2011, how do people book their slots? Is there a fee that they have to pay if they want to join?
Yeah, I think the fee is $2,025, right? Is there an early bird? So it's $2,500.
$2,500 already, okay.
Yeah, they can register online, or they can give us a call.
Okay, all right. And that's happening next week already.
Yes.
Right, and there are limited slots. I think Randall was saying earlier, 30 to 40 slots. So if you want to join, it's best to sign up. All right, maybe you'd like to invite our viewers and their kids to Blue Chip 2011.
Yeah, please join us at the upcoming Blue Chip seminar, May 4 and 5. If I can go back in time and I was younger, this is something that I really wouldn't miss. So bring your kids along. They will really learn a lot from this seminar.
Okay, great. Jason Law, thank you so much for coming on Shop Talk.
Thank you.
All right, and thank all of you for watching Shop Talk. I'm Ria Tanjuatco Trillo. Please follow ANC Shop Talk on Twitter and be a fan of ANC Shop Talk on Facebook. Join us again tomorrow as we talk about the latest technology in fitness apparel and footwear. Enjoy the rest of your day.